Welcome to another video about the brand new Microsoft Edge web browser control from TMS. This control is available for the VCL and for FireMonkey. Please watch the introductory video if this is the first time you hear about this component. It'll be in the comments. I'm sure our marketing department will link it for you. In this video, I would like to look at another key feature in detail: printing and exporting. An export is available to the Adobe PDF format in particular. If you download the trial or own this product, TMS provides this very example that I'm showing right now as the Edge printing example. You'll find it in the demo folder. This example shows you how you can print and export the content of the browser window to PDF. Before looking at the implementation, as always, I'm going to run the demonstration right here, make it a little bit bigger so you can see it. By default, we go to the tmssoftware.com page, and I provided an example right here. This is a GitHub repository and rather complex to render to print. And here we have like source code and a readme.md file, which is markup that GitHub translates into viewable HTML content. So there's quite a lot of stuff to see here, source code, and also different graphics. This is a pretty good example, especially, for example, if you generate HTML content for your invoices or other documents that still need to be in paper or PDF. The buttons on the bottom allow you to print, invoking the user interface. This user interface comes out of the browser control, as you can see right here. This is not the control from the operating system. Obviously, as Edge is Windows, this is pretty close to what it looks like in Windows now, but still, this comes out of the WebView2 library. And I'll print this. I have no preview because I'm running this in a virtual machine on a macOS system, so the printer drivers don't really come forward for a preview. However, if I print this, I get the dialog from my operating system, and I can immediately see here that the PDF is printed correctly. I get all my printers and I can now save it as PDF so I can show it to you what my printout will look like. This is the PDF file on my Mac system, printed from the web page. So everything is on there. There's nothing missing. I have here the top of the page, all the icons, buttons, and everything is rendered correctly. And even colors and the wrapping across the pages properly. Nothing is cut off. The document printed nicely. So this is a real good printout that you could use. However, printing nowadays is, as you just saw, you either wanted to print it to a PDF stream or to a PDF file, or alternatively here on the right side, you don't need to invoke the print UI. You can directly print to the default printer that's selected on your operating system. Let's look at the implementation. Starting with print UI, it's one line of code. You call the method show print UI. The dialog is being shown, and the user has, of course, the option to cancel out. With regards to printing directly, you load the initial print settings in a special data structure, the TTMS FNC web browser print settings, and there you can customize the settings if you want to deviate from the default settings that are set in the operating system. The data structure is filled with defaults, and then you can make adjustments. Of course, this means you could show your own dialog, your own settings, fill those settings into that data structure, and then print directly without showing the user interface from Edge. That might be something you prefer, that you say, hey, I have all these settings in my own application. I don't want to use what Microsoft provides because I don't like the new design that Microsoft has in there. I rather use the design that matches my application. So this way you're able to control the printing process with your settings without just accepting the defaults. And then you call the print method and pass the print settings as a parameter. Now coming over to the PDF functionality, printing to a PDF stream. is really print to PDF stream. And you might think, where do I specify the PDF stream, right? Like, well, as a lot of things on the web, it's an asynchronous process. That means if you call print to PDF stream, you trigger inside of the control, please print or please give me a PDF stream with the information that is shown right now in the control. And how you can access that is if you look at the events of the control. So here, let's filter by PDF. And there is the event on get PDF stream. And if we look at that, we get as a parameter as type T memory stream, which is a stream in memory, the stream of the PDF. So this allows us very, very easily to either use this data to put it in a database or to send it over a web service, whatever you want to do, you have it inside of a stream. The easiest thing, of course, in this case is to save it to a file and you specify the file name right here. But that is T memory stream specific functionality. Of course, nobody hinders you to convert your T memory stream into another stream. You have access to the data, and the data is the PDF of your printed document. The most important thing to remember is call print to PDF stream, and then at some point in the future, get print PDF stream will be triggered if the printing process is successful. And there you then need to use the astream parameter in order to process the result. Finally, printing to PDF is giving you the ability to specify a file name. So in this case, you do not have to listen for an event because the framework can do that for you. TMS provided that functionality for you. You just say print to a PDF file, and then TMS implements the whole asynchronous process for you. You just specify the file name, and at some point in the future, this file will be created and it will contain the information from the web browser. Of course, with this kind of structure, you lose a little bit more of the flexibility. You have it in a file. Sometimes you just want the information in memory and then process that information somewhere else. So print to PDF is really the go-to if you need a file on the disk, then you can use print to PDF. And if you want to use the PDF data somewhere else in the future, use print to PDF stream and then process that stream accordingly. That's it for now with another key feature of the TMS Edge web browser component. Please subscribe to this channel to keep up to date with all new things TMS, and also give it a thumbs up if you like the content that we provide. Take care. See you.